It's Thursday night, and you know what that means, folks. It's time for ACW. I'm your host, the Frenchiest Fry in all of the trash cans, Kuma Raccoon, and alongside me are my co-hosts, the poofiest pillow doggo around, Blitzkrieg, and the greediest weasel you know, Manny Mustel.
You know, I just want the things in this world that belong to me that I am entitled to and deserve, and that makes me greedy.
Yes, because about half of the things you feel entitled to don't actually belong to you, Manny.
That gets decided in a courtroom, not here.
Don't drag me into it.
Well, we are not in a courtroom, ladies and gentlemen. We are in a wrestling ring, and we have a stacked card here tonight. As in our opening match, we're going to have Willow in action, issuing an open challenge to any wrestler, regardless if they're on the ACW roster or not. She is issuing a challenge to anyone, as she definitely has an axe to grind here tonight, folks. As you know, she was in the tournament, the ACW World Championship Tournament, but was out in the first round as she was eliminated by Muraku Frostmane. And even though she did have a really good showing over in Showcase against Jin Sung a while back, she definitely has a point to prove here tonight. Gentlemen, what do you think about Willow's matchup tonight? Who do you think might even answer her challenge here?
You know, it's one thing to win on Showcase. It's another thing to actually win when you got the big crowd, the lights, you know, the cameras, everything going on. It's definitely more pressure as for who's going to answer the challenge. I don't know.
I couldn't begin to guess who's going to answer this challenge. There's such a huge amount of talent both on our roster and in the local areas that it's just a complete blind guessing game. As to Willow herself, though, there is something about her that is just appealing. I can't explain it, but I find myself on Manny's side with her. I don't get it.
Oh, that is very surprising. So we'll see who answers that open challenge here in just a moment. But in our main event, it is a big one, as we are going to see tag team action as the Irish Killer and the Victorian Vigilante, Dani McPherson and Samantha E. Gehring, team up to take on Kojo's acolytes, Alucard and Lilith, the Hellhounds. And gentlemen, this match is monumental, and just like, can Dani and Samantha coexist here? Like, as we know, they had a match a few weeks ago and they did not see eye to eye at all. Blitz, you know Dani better than anyone here. Can those two get along?
Absolutely. Dani's professionalism is a step above. She could work with Jack Spade against a common enemy, and those two would be able to work together to take that common enemy down. That's just how professional she is.
Of course, because Jack Spade would carry her the whole damn way. Listen, this is a fight for their survival. Now, if zombies were attacking, I don't like you two, but you know what? You gotta do what you gotta do in order to survive. And that's exactly the type of situation that Dani finds herself in tonight, as well as Samantha as well. So it's you know, join or, you know, go die, you know? I mean, you get the point. I mean, this is the Hellhounds, and I tell you what, from experience, they are not a fun group to wrestle against.
No. I'm not sure where you drag zombies into this, but no, I'm not concerned about Dani and Samantha. Those two are going to be able to mesh together. They're going to be able to work together, defeat the Hellhounds, and then set their sights on their next target. No question.
Well, we'll see if those two can coexist here tonight, but that is our main event, and now we are going to start off the show with Willow's Open Challenge. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen, kicking off our opening contest with her open challenge tonight, the master of the tiger kick, Willow.
She's undisciplined, she's untrained as relatively, but she's agile, she's quick, she's fast. I don't get it, but I like pulling for her. She's a bad guy, but I dig it.
you know, the thing is, I mean, yeah, you mentioned her undisciplined, but she's not untrained by any means. She's just that one student that likes to kind of get ahead of the instructor and, you know, that kind of stuff.
Well, it's time to see who's going to answer her open challenge here tonight. As... not familiar with this theme song. Yeah, definitely not someone from
ACW. I think
ACW.
I am.
Well, is it Manny, do you
know? From the Amphibious Order? Oh, my goodness. Sir Fribbert from the Amphibious Order, Fribbert Frumpington.
Wow.
I cannot believe that I am seeing this guy. You know, he actually is like a kingdom guard. You know, so he rarely gets time to go out and compete.
I'm sorry,
got his sword.
What
the?
Yes, he has a sword. Well, let's hope he doesn't use his matches. It's underway right now. Here we go. And they
I'm still trying to process what I just saw right there for a second.
That was a sword, but I'm pretty sure Valencia made sure that it was put away and won't be used for this match, thankfully.
Hopefully it's not still in his possession at all.
He's a knight. That's his job. That's what he does for a living.
Well, he's in a wrestling match now and not in a battlefield where... Oh my goodness!
Massive agility from Willow! Wow!
My.
Absolutely.
The flexibility from that tiger.
I tell you what, though. Yeah, Fribbert is very disciplined. And that is something that Willow... We got to see how much she's improved. Has she picked up that discipline? Because if she has not, Fribbert could make short work of her. I'm just saying.
Another fantastic display of agility from Willow there, dodging that massive froggy hit.
And they block him again. And a judo toss from Willow. Very impressive. Using that martial arts skill to her advantage here.
And you know what? Fribbert's not used to it. Not used to fighting against folks with martial arts skills and stuff, you know?
Yeah, martial artists don't typically do all this grappling and, you know, pinning and anything, all of that stuff.
Oh, a spinning toe hold. Wow, a move from Terry Funk's old playbook.
Indeed.
Willa's not letting him get away with it. She popped him in the face twice during that exchange.
A couple of times.
Oh, and a side headlock takedown. Wow, very old school. Great. Old school kind of wrestling here in a bit for these two.
Damn. Yeah, I think we might have teleported back to 1985 right here.
Damn. I tell you what, I know a certain someone that's won a couple matches that way.
Well, that's never here or there at the moment.
Yeah, sure.
Miss kick. Oh, that kick connected from Willow. Oh, now, it definitely looks like Willow definitely has the speed advantage here.
Explorer suplex definitely has the size advantage. It's not going to matter all that much, though, with a massive kick to the face.
She calls that the Haluva kick, if I'm not mistaken. A very, very well-placed kick, and Willow's definitely known for that.
Nice punch right there. Just me, or does Fribbert kind of look like the Gorn from Star Trek?
I was just about to say the exact same thing. Do we see Jean-Luc Picard in the audience?
It was Kirk. Kirk fought him.
I swear. Oh, the tiger kick! The tiger kick! This might be it!
Yeah, it's a pin. It could be it.
Two. No, it's not it, though. Fribbert is still in this.
Almost.
Very close.
Punch to the face, and...
Look at this Fribbert. Oh, I thought for a second going for the cover.
This frog has his own agility by the looks of it.
The
tiger
fairly
kick!
Impressive. That's got to be in the
okay,
ropes.
Okay, that's too... Yeah.
No way.
Good eye from Valencia, though. Very good eye from Valencia. Strike right there. And a headbutt.
Massive
headbutt.
Wow. Why not?
Very strong. Oh, using all of his body weight.
Power
here comes
move.
A pin.
Here we go. Pin right
Two.
Here.
No,
that
not enough.
Nope. Got to wear it out.
Oh my god. What did we just see?
She just kicked him out of the air.
Oh my god.
What in the Hadouken?
Oh
my
god.
Goodness.
He was in the air and she intercepted him with her foot.
I am speechless. But
I can't. Yeah.
The frog's did not benefit her all that much, though, because she's now on the defense.
And the spinning toe hold again.
Oh, she's popping him.
I mean,
every time he turns, she pops him in the face.
Frumpington is a
and
tough
he could not
customer.
Handle three pops.
Oh, the kick to the face.
Oh, giant kick right
you do
there.
Gizagiri.
Willow. I don't care how well trained or how tough you are. You take too many of those kicks.
Hold on. What's he doing here?
Oh, what's it? Somebody's getting froggy here.
Oh, my God.
It is indeed the frumpington elbow.
Oh,
there it is. This could be it. One, two, and three. No.
I don't think Willow was ready for. Oh my God!
That might be it right there. One and two, and this could be it.
Well out. No.
I don't think Willow was ready for this. I mean, she was expecting some no name, but Frumpington is putting up a fight here.
I'm gonna say something here. She expected a jobber. She did not get a jobber. She got somebody who knows precisely what they're doing in this ring.
Wow.
Frumpington is well trained. Oh, I mean,
he's going for it again.
The most electrifying move
in sports entertainment today.
The most electrifying move from the lily pad. Yeah, that's what it is. And he gets the elbow right there. That should be it.
That's not it. Oh, a pin.
Oh, one. Another pin here.
Two.
That's a quick one.
Are you kidding me?
And almost.
Near fall. Again, this has to be another one.
Could be it here.
Oh my God!
Oh, again.
It's a striking exchange between the tiger and the frog.
Each other in the
this is
of the
intense.
Ring.
Oh, he's tiger her up.
This.
Kick to the head. Oh my God!
Square in the back of the head. Recover.
That could be it right there.
Two,
and
three.
That is gonna be it.
Oh my God. God.
What a match that we just saw.
Holy moly, she took his head off with that kick.
And you know, Willow looks better than last year.
She does. She definitely
looks
does.
Better than what she did in season one.
Very impressive win here by
Where
Willow
is she
tonight.
Going?
She's leaving
the school. Hey, that guy owes me money. He owes me money.
You had to win. You didn't win.
No. It was for the match, not for the win.
Hold on. It looks like they're having some kind of exchange right now. I can't read what they're saying. It's not being their lips, but
clearly VIP
is
impressed with what he just
to him. Jeez. Willow, don't do it.
Don't do it. He's a ripoff. He won't pay you.
He was.
Holy shit! I'm agreeing with Manny.
VIP was looking for a tag team partner. Could VIP be trying to recruit Willow here?
He doesn't pay his partners like he's supposed to recruit
Willow because his last partner folded like a wet blanket.
You know what? I did not fold. I made the Jackson lead. Okay, thank you very much.
By the Jackson.
You know what?
You
I powerbombed them so many.
You two stop arguing.
Listen,
he
owes me money.
Stop arguing. We have to go to the commercial. Crypto, take us away.
Do you live near one of these dots? If so, then you have a pro table derby team repping your city. But no worries if you don't, because on the Car Demolition League's YouTube channel, you'll have free season tickets for every team. The games are quick and competitive, so if you don't like watching long, boring 3-hour games, this is the stuff for you. The CDL will have a dozen done for you in just over an hour, every week, all summer long. Or if you're really in a hurry, just check the timestamps in the description, and you can jump right to your favorite team's match. All of last year's games are available to view, and the 2024 season smashes off this April. The Car Demolition. Get wrecked with us.
Wow, hang on to her, buddy! That two car was all over the place!
Busher is going to do it. He goes back to back. He'll win in Michigan. Chase Elliott is a NASCAR Cup Series champion.
Yeah! Look at this.
Four. Here they come to the flag. Three abreast. Photo finish.
Yeah!
Manny, I don't care if you know the guy. Willow just kicked the shit out of him, kicked his head off. End of story.
End of your story.
Would you two stop arguing? You were arguing the whole commercial break, for God's sake. We have another match here to focus on. The main event.
Oh, that's right. We get to see Dani and Sam kick some ass.
Well, and here comes the first member of that weird tag team, Samantha E. Gehring.
Yes, Samantha Gehring, very talented, but the wondering is, can she actually make this work with Dani? I don't know. Dani, tough to work with. They're going to have to figure out a way tonight.
Dani's not tough to work with if you're on the same side as her. She's obviously going to buck against anybody on the opposite.
You mean if you're just as drunk as her?
That may or may not be true.
Stop arguing, for God's sakes. Just stop with the fight. You're not in the ring. These competitors are in the ring, and here comes Samantha's partner, the Irish killer, the baddest bitch in ACW, Dani McPherson.
Aw, oh, you stole my line. I was going to say that.
God, who cares? It's a line regardless.
Dani, she is absolutely going to kick some ass tonight. I am ready for this. Anybody got
flipping
some bourbon?
Off the entire crowd. You know, used to be such a nice workplace here.
It is a nice workplace. She has your back if you're a good guy.
Well,
What's happening here? What the hell is going on here?
It was a nice workplace. Until these guys came along.
There, I have to agree with Kuma.
Yeah, same.
That same
Holy moly,
chill,
three for three.
That same chill in the arena as when Kojo makes his appearance. Here they come, ladies and gentlemen. Kojo's acolytes. Satan's fraternal Hellhound twins. Alucard, Lilith, the Hellhound.
Chance against Samantha and Dani.
Don't doubt
Not
them.
One
no
chance.
Blitz. Don't yeah, doubt
I'm
them.
I'm telling you, Blitz.
Manny
I'm telling
and
you,
I
Blitz. I
no first.
No, evil. Good always triumphs over evil. I learned that from Heel. Hey, that's how this is gonna work.
This is not a TV
you know,
show, Blitz. This is reality. And here we go.
Try to explain simple things like this, but the brain damage he has.
This
just
match is underway.
Watch it.
Let's hope Dani and Samantha can actually get along here and take down these Hellhounds. Oh my God! Lilith is trying to snap her neck.
I think that's what he. That's I think what she tried to do was break her neck. Imagine that. First thing that she does is go for a kill shot.
We're already
no
going
pun intended.
For gross bodily injury in this match tonight. A second huge miss on a spear from Lilith.
These Hellhounds are not going to pull any punches, and a bulldog from Dani. What a counter. Oh my God.
Holy moly, Dani just got lifted off the ground like a child.
Using that Hellhound power.
Did they just breathe fire?
They have a habit of doing that. Both of them can, actually. I don't know how that's possible, but they can.
That seems
unfair. Are
they
brother and sister? What's their relationship?
Yes. They are fraternal twins.
Manny, they are fraternal twins. By definition, that means they are brother and sister.
Yes, they were born at the same time. They, even though they do kind of look alike, they don't look exactly alike. And Samantha goes behind. And a Russian leg sweep by Alucard. My goodness. You know, what's scary about these two when it comes to Alucard and Lilith, like, I don't know which one is scarier or more powerful. Like, they both have equal amount of strength. Oh my God, reversing that Samoa.
Yeah, here we go. Is this an armbar right there? No.
I mean, I'm not necessarily sure it matters which one of them is more powerful when they're working as a team.
And they do make for a very dangerous
duo.
These two had a match in Showcase not too long ago, and they just obliterated their opponents in that match. Like, it wasn't even close.
Tagging out to Dani, not that it really made a whole lot of
difference.
Look
at that. Two big boots, man.
Oh! And strike exchange between the border collie and the Hellhound. Here we go.
Danny's not going to back down from this guy.
Oh!
He takes him off his feet.
Oh, Alucard, he's not down. The pin!
Look at that reversal.
Look at that agility from Dani to get out of that without pin.
I think the shatter machine.
The Hellhounds even more.
Brutal. God, just an elbow.
Huge chop to the chest.
And, oh, wow.
And look at this.
I'm not sure.
I think that is.
I'm not sure what that is.
Like a sharpshooter or a cloverleaf.
No, it was not really either, but very good move by Lilith right there. And, uh-oh. Oh, Dan's calling for it.
She's calling for her big dude.
The rolling elbow. God, I love it when she does that move.
Oh, I love it. I love the agility on display when she does that move. Manny, are you having a stroke?
Just about.
Oh, wow. What? Wait
what
a minute.
Was that? That was something special just then.
That tag team move, that was a move that Dani and Muraoku would
That
use.
Was a Dani and Muraoku special right there. Cross shooter.
Not focusing on him right now. You need to focus on this match.
Yeah, speaking of Muraoku, where is he?
I don't know where he is. Don't bring him up right now, okay?
He's not relevant.
Why can't we? Why can't we bring him up right now? What happened the last time that he was in the ring?
Shut up, Manny!
Big old miss from Lilith right there. Alucard, I apologize.
Oh, my God, it stomps to the face. And oh, wow. God, just pounding on his forehead.
Attacking the face of Alucard. Well,
but that's what Samantha and Dani need to do. Like the Hellhounds are not going to hold back. They are aggressive, so they need to match fire with fire here. And, oh, my God, what is this? Oh, my God, a curve.
Look at that.
Oh, my God. I'm surprised Danny's nose is not broken after that.
McPherson needs to tap out for it. It needs to bail out for just a second to recover from that one. That was absolutely vicious.
Yeah. Oh, God. Another shatter machine by the Hellhounds. Good God. Picking her up.
It's hard for me to even root for the Hellhounds, too. I'll
shoulder grapple right there?
It was a shoulder claw. No. The bloody cross from Lilith. Oh, this God, this might be it. That might be it.
Cocky pin. And he's gonna kick him straight in the spine.
It ain't about being cocky. It's about actually, you know,
that's sending a message.
You know,
that's sending a message right there. And Samantha kicking her, and a hip attack from the Snow Leopard.
Flings her back into the ring.
Tag out to Dani. And throws her to the corner, but to Alucard's corner. I don't know about that
corner.
Oh, wait, what's that? Oh, you're setting up? Oh, and a spike power driver from Dani and Samantha. I must say.
The teamwork that they're showing off is pretty impressive. I gotta say that.
It's very impressive.
Samantha and
Dani
have definitely figured out how to operate as a team.
The Hellhound special. God.
It's working extremely well right now.
It's definitely working well right now, but the thing is can they keep it up here? I mean, they need to, though. I think it's more of a need of necessity.
Otherwise, they're gonna lose.
That's right.
It's not lose. You understand. It's not that they're going to lose. It's that they will die, okay? You cannot. I mean, these two.
Well, I don't know about dying.
Man.
The cross shooter again.
The cross shooter combo!
Yeah.
I don't know. We were both pretty close there, weren't we there, Kuma?
Shut up.
Faye?
What the hell? Is that. Where the hell did that chair
come
from?
It's a concerto.
From?
That's what
Where
it is.
Where did these chairs come from? What? Dani didn't
Your
even
reign.
Have a chance to respond.
I mean, Wendy just lets it happen, you know? If you had Eagle in there, maybe.
How does Wendy.
Did you see how quickly that actually happened? Wendy or Dani had no chance to respond to that.
Yeah, Dani did. She was right there. She didn't do anything.
Plus, I'm not sure.
I'm sorry. Let's see your friend get smacked in the face with a chair and have you immediately jump in to do something about it and not be stunned for just a second.
I would have moved right as soon as I saw the chair.
I don't buy it.
Yeah. Wait, hold on. And the Shadow of the Cross
don't
from Samantha. Shadow of the Cross. That might be it. No.
Danny trying to win interference. It's not going to work.
That was Samantha's best move right there. If
the Hellhounds are on solid offense here.
This is it right here.
Why didn't Dani break
it? Danny's not breaking. Yeah, good question. Why doesn't Dani break it?
Maybe they're not getting along. I don't know. They're giving us mixed signals here. Are they getting along?
You know what?
Not?
Maybe Dani. Maybe Dani is scared now because this match has gone on longer. She's taking more punishment. And maybe she just wants to get it over with by having Samantha take the fall pin.
You have to
ever think of that.
Word scared does not exist in Dani's vocabulary. That bitch is not scared of anything.
Dani's match with Kojo is next week, and that is for the ACW World Heavyweight Championship. So you know that the longer this match goes on, the more tired she might be for next week in her big match.
Bingo. Strategy.
Going back to that, Dani.
And that could be
Dani
it right here.
Hold
pin,
back just
pin,
a little bit.
Pin. Look at this, Samantha. Oh, look, Samantha helps out.
Gosh, it took a number of
Dani helped her
out
in the turn earlier in the match. It's playing. It's hit for tat.
Ankle lock.
But didn't get her last time. Didn't help her out the last time when she was getting pinned.
But are they still alive in this match? Yes, they are.
But they
they're still, thanks to Samantha.
They definitely need to end it here quick, though. Like, this match has gone on for way too long. And
massive rolling elbow once again tags out to Samantha.
Yep, go on and get out of the ring. She's too scared to stay in there.
Oh, the cross-shooter combination again!
Yep, cross-shooter right
move.
Here. That
good
could
move.
Be it.
All right, you guys, you made your point.
And where's Alucard?
Alucard turning on his sister, not being willing. Oh, there he is.
Well, it just... The Hellhounds
maybe
trust...
they like seeing each other.
What an upper-clean house right there.
Here we go, the strike exchange. The strike exchange between the Snow Leopard and the Hellhound. Who's going to come
you
up on top?
You know what?
Oh, she just ate that.
Oh, get ready
right
to
this by Samantha. God.
You know what? I'm going to say something pretty bold here. This is my hot take of the night, that Samantha is carrying Dani in this match.
Oh, zero chance. She is attacked in the back of Alucard's head right there. Like, he's trying
to do it's easy to hit a man when he's down.
Oh, no, wait, hold on. This is Alucard's biggest move. The strike to hell power.
And there it is. It could be, look at that, Samantha right there to help Dani out. If it wasn't for Samantha.
Know that if it was the other way around, Dani would have been all over that.
You know, I'm really impressed with Samantha
right here. Okay, stop using that move. I get it.
Cross-shooter. Cross-shooter locked in.
It's going to be effective.
That could be it. It's been very effective.
That's not it.
It's just keep... It,
you know,
what a
shot.
Oh, my
God. Gehring.
That was straight out of Tekken right there.
And
oh
that could be it. That's gotta be it. That's gotta be the three. Oh my goodness, how did she kick out?
He has lost control of this match. What is going on?
So much
she
chaos.
Has,
oh,
absolutely.
Lariat from Samantha. And, oh no, he's going for it again.
Alucard.
There it is right there.
That's gotta be it.
Just slam them onto the mat.
Dani
like
saved her. Dani saved her right there. Wait,
Step
Rider! And
did she sober up finally?
God.
Look at this submission maneuver
the
right here, and it's over. There's
the
a tap. There's a tap. There's a tap right there.
Alucard
just tapped out to Samantha Gehring.
Incredible!
They got it, and Samantha picks up the win for her team. What a win! What a
Whoa! Lights are out. We're dark again.
Why aren't the lights on?
Oh no!
Get your hands off me, please.
Shut up.
Oh no. It's him.
It's Kojo.
It's the ACW World Champion Kojo, and he's staring down Dani and Samantha.
She's calling him out. She's calling him to the ring.
Right now.
Is she though? Oh, yes.
She wants him.
She wants him to come in. Of course, because she got Samantha right there.
Is Kojo about to enter the ring? Are we about to lose the preview
of
next week?
Of course not.
I don't think so.
Do it.
No, he's going to save it for when it matters the most, and he's not outnumbered.
Oh, the big demon horse is scared of two females significantly smaller than him.
Wow.
You know what? After you just saw Samantha made one of those hellhounds tap out tonight now, didn't she?
Well,
she carried Dani that whole match, didn't she?
You have to remember, too, Kojo unofficially tapped out once before to another Snow Leopard, so you may have a point there, but Dani is going to have a huge, huge opportunity next week as she takes on Kojo one-on-one for the ACW World Heavyweight Championship, and you do not want to miss that. Be sure to join us here next Thursday night at the same time, 6 p.m. Pacific time, 9 p.m. Eastern, and can Dani pull up the upset? Can Dani McPherson end the reign of terror of the Demon Horde? universe.